Hi, I'm Sheila Sani, and we're coming to you live from SCAI-TV, the Scientific Sessions 2018, San Diego, California. And I'm joined with an excellent congenital heart team.
I'm Lee Benson from the Hospital for Sick Children in Toronto, and I'm a pediatric interventional cardiologist.
I'm Dennis Kim from Children's Healthcare of Atlanta and Emory University.
And I'm John Moore. I'm from in town at Rady Children's Hospital in UCSD.
And Dr. Moore just presented a live case, so we're going to start with him. Tell us about the performance in a live case and how you can get tips and tricks across to a large audience.
Complicated question. I have to say that my partner did the case, and I was more the narrator and cheerleader. So Dr. El-Sayed did the case. What we presented was just a fairly straightforward melody valve implant in the pulmonary position in an RV to pulmonary reconduit. We were really demonstrating sort of a standard technique that probably all of us use. So I think that we had a couple of goals. One was to demonstrate to a wider audience than is used to seeing congenital interventions, in other words, structural cardiologists, other kinds of interventional cardiologists, the sort of things that we do, which I think they're not that familiar with, many of them. And then secondly, to demonstrate how pediatric cardiologists who are also congenital cardiologists can integrate into a team that takes care of adults. So we did this at our adult facility with our adult partners and was adult patient. So I think we had those goals. I don't think that Dennis or Lee learned anything from the procedure. They might have some comments about what we could have done better or differently. But I think that in terms of the membership of SCAI at large, we were hoping to communicate a little bit to them, like what we do, and also to talk about the kind of teams that are possible to assemble in communities like ours.
Dr. Benson, how have you found that taking care of patients in Canada, when you come over to the U.S. for meetings here, how is the management different? Does it differ?
No, the management doesn't differ. I mean, the diseases
are the same.
But
the healthcare system processes.
They are very different.
Yeah.
Yes. I don't want to be too political about it, but I can. The differences are actually very stark because we don't have to worry about the insurance or the cost of something. Patients come into the hospital, we identify a problem that needs to be addressed, and I won't say money's no object because it is. I mean, we have to be fiscally responsible, but it doesn't come into play when we think about whether the patient needs an intervention that could be very expensive, or they have to stay in line to wait until there's some budgetary constraints. It's a completely different way of thinking about how to deal with the problems for the children and the adults, particularly adults with congenital heart disease, and that's something that happened in this institute, in this meeting. There are several meetings addressing adults with congenital heart disease, and talking about guidelines for interventional cardiologists and how they fit into the treatment of patients who have congenital heart disease. They've become adults, and I think we both know that. Yet, I think it was in 2000 or 2005 that it turns out now there's more adults with congenital heart disease than children with congenital heart disease. Mm-hmm. So it's a huge burgeoning population, and it's a population of individuals where adult cardiologists are not trained to deal with them. Mm-hmm. And there's a huge void in how to look after this patient population. And that's one thing that came out of this meeting in some sub-meetings within the society about how the society is going to address and make recommendations for management and training for that population. I mean, John's case was an adult with congenital heart disease.
Right.
Dr. Kim, let's hear from you regarding what exciting new trends came out at this meeting in addition to this important finding.
I think that this meeting is a great meeting for us as pediatric cardiologists because there are all kinds of new techniques, new ways of dealing with problems, new approaches that even seasoned veterans can learn to take back home to treat their patients. Unlike the adult community, we typically don't have trials that involve thousands of patients, very elaborate kinds of things. And so, you know, a lot of what we do is by learning from each other. And I think SCAI serves a particularly good purpose in allowing us to kind of get all our brains together and impart wisdom onto the younger interventionalists that are coming along too.
And what are you most excited about, Dr. Moore?
I think there were a lot of exciting sessions that we put together here, and I didn't get to every single one of them, but most of them I did. I really enjoyed the session where we discussed different ways of palliating cyanotic newborns, where we discussed the use of stents, inductuses, stents, and RV outflow tract, and we even invited a surgeon here who pointed out some things that we should think about, I think, along the way. But this is a relatively new approach at many centers, and I think that we can learn a lot from each other, and it's interesting to see what data we do have assembled at different centers, because as Dennis points out, we don't have large trials with large numbers, but certainly, for example, at Lee's Hospital, the Hospital for Sick Children, they have quite a bit of experience with the RV outflow tract stent, which they shared with us and was quite good information, and I think may encourage some of us to pursue that pathway.
Dr. Benson, how do you engage younger residents, cardiology fellows, to take an interest in this field and specialty? What advice would you give them?
Well, I think it has to start from their interest. I use the term, it has to sort of burn in their belly. There has to be a fire in their belly to want to pursue interventional cardiology. Trainees get some experience in the laboratory throughout their core fellowship, and those that have an interest, knock on the door, and those that have, we identify that have the technical skills, we can then enhance their cognitive abilities to pursue the field of interventional cardiology. It has to start from the individual.
One of the unique things about our specialty is that we groom from pediatrics residents, typically, and then people who are going in our field. And as we see the demographics of who is going into pediatrics residencies right now, it's become dominated by women. And we had the opportunity to recognize one of the women leaders in our field at our Mullins lecture this year. She gave a very nice talk describing the very important contributions that women have been making towards our specialty since the early 1900s. And that was a special moment for us. I thought that was that's something I think that may spark interest in those people who are going through medical training to want to do what we do.
Absolutely. Well, having pediatric interventional cardiologists and the congenital heart team from the interventional perspective attached to SCAI makes it more of an enriching society. So thank you. And thanks for joining us for the interview.